Wherever you find yourself between the east and west coast of Canada, small emblems of civilization can be found amongst the rock, forest, prairie, and waterways of the country. The Great Trail was conceived in 1992, of a route that spanned the breadth of Canada and served as a venue for a variety of outdoor activities. The citizens of each province maintain and improve the thousands of kilometers of trail, with local committees identifying unique spots to develop. This video documents the improvement of one such section, the Cabin Lake Trail, in Manitoba's Whiteshell Provincial Park. Construction began on this portion of the trail far from the wilderness, in Kings Park, Winnipeg. This pedestrian bridge was one of two removed and replaced with universally accessible bridges by Pier Solutions. Pier then refurbished both bridges and in the first of two projects for Trails Manitoba, installed one of the bridges at Hanson's Creek in 2019, also in Whiteshell Provincial Park. The second project at Cabin Lake began in earnest in January of 2020. The site, just off Highway 307, is rugged with alternating shield, forest, and lakes. Because of the terrain, getting materials into site wasn't going to be easy, and since the heaviest individual component of the bridge, the girders, could be lifted by helicopter, it was decided that flying everything into site would be the quickest and easiest option. The morning before the lift, a meeting is held among Pier staff and the pilot from provincial helicopters to go over safety details. At this point, the weather forecast is firm enough that the helicopter will almost certainly fly the next day, no matter the temperature. Once everyone is briefed, the staff gets bundled up, and the raw materials, bridge components, and tools and equipment all start getting loaded up and taken out to the liftoff site. Day is clear and bright and cold, minus 27 degrees Celsius. Final components are loaded and begin their trek east from Winnipeg into the forest and shield. Once everyone has made the trek to the liftoff site, final details are discussed with the pilot's ground crew. Everyone then splits into two groups, those at the liftoff point who will prepare the material for the lift, and the team at the drop point, which lies several kilometers away, where they wait for the sound of the helicopter to arrive with its first load of material. Snow has fallen over the weekend, making for difficult progress getting up to site. Once on location, one of the first tasks is to build some shelter. Tools can easily get buried in a snowfall up here, and having a place to warm up is a good idea, even if it doesn't get used. Once the site is prepped, work can begin on the bridge itself. The crew starts clearing the snow along the shore on either side of the bridge site. The bridge girders will rest on custom-made steel brackets that will be bolted onto the rock on both shores, and holes need to be drilled into the rock for this. But the lower part of the brackets will sit below the level of the water, which means digging down through the ice to where the mount holes will begin. After access to these locations is gained, a simple 3D layout of the site can be referenced, and the points where the holes need to be drilled can be marked. The goal, in terms of margin for error on the layout, is under a millimeter. Holes drilled, the brackets are carefully positioned and leveled. Grout will be poured into the space around the bolts as well as around the base of the brackets to lock everything into place. After it's given time to set up, the next phase of the project begins. The two heavy girders need to be placed on top of their steel brackets, but a second constraint now exists, and that's the thickness of the ice on the way out to site. A slower, more low-tech approach could be used for the lift, but it's calculated that a sweet spot exists between the weight the ice will hold and the size and lifting power of the equipment that can cross it. Once safely out to sight, the tricky part begins. Between the weight of the girders and the uneven ground, any unexpected moves can easily tip these little excavators over. Cold weather has returned, but the team is prepared with propane to heat the excavators. They gradually warm up while the girders and brackets are ready, and after lunch, the equipment starts. The buckets are removed on the excavators to give them a little extra lifting capacity, and the dance with the girders begins. We'll be right back. technical complexity of the project eases at this point, as the bridge simply needs to be reassembled. However, as anybody who's ever built anything knows, there are always complications. Consumables are needed that are back in the tool trailer, tools break that are only available back in Winnipeg, and things that made sense in theory don't work out in practice. The cold snap is over as well, and it's late in the winter, and while warm weather makes work faster, the ponds and streams that feed Cabin Lake will soon start funneling water down to where they converge, which is just above the bridge site. Cabin Lake Trail in Whiteshell Provincial Park is open and ready for use, with increased accessibility year-round to a picnic site and excellent fishing on a pleasant 4.6 kilometer round-trip hike. Pier Solutions, Trails Manitoba, and the Trans-Canada Trail Association are proud to present the Cabin Lake Bridge to their fellow residents of Manitoba and citizens of Canada.